Games Afoot was a departure for me somewhat because it's a mystery. It's a real Agatha Christie-like mystery, if you will, set in a spooky house. It's a house owned by a famous actor, and he's a real historical character named William Gillette. And he was the guy who wrote Sherlock Holmes. So he would bring, historically, his cast from Broadway when he was playing in Sherlock Holmes. He'd bring them up to this castle he built on the Connecticut River. And it still exists today. It's a tourist attraction. You can go visit it. And it's crazy. The guy was a true American eccentric. It looks like a castle from the outside. It has hidden doors and hidden rooms and lots of tricky mirrors around so he could see his guests before they walked in the door. And it's tons of fun. So I thought, what if William Gillette invited his cast from New York, who are all in a mystery, Sherlock Holmes, so there's somebody who plays Watson, there's somebody who plays Professor Moriarty, and he invites them for a weekend of fun, but what happens is there's a murder, a real murder, and Gillette goes into his Sherlock Holmes mode, because he's been playing Holmes for two decades, and he, in a sense, becomes Sherlock Holmes. And he solves the mystery. But at the same time, I wanted to keep it light and funny. So it functions also, it has real farcical moments when they try to move the dead body and they know people are coming into the room and these two guys, the guy who plays Sherlock, William Gillette, and the one who plays his Dr. Watson character, are desperately trying to get this dead body into a closet. It's that irreverence for death that often fuels farce, that often fuels comedy in general. And so what they do is they, and a bit of advice if you ever do The Games Afoot, is just like all comedies play for the high stakes. When they think somebody's coming to, when Gillette thinks somebody's coming to arrest his mother for the murder, he goes into high gear to protect her because that's where the heart of the play is. And the heart's what always matters. But on top of that, in this case, make sure you play it with precision. When they're trying to get in and out of those doors and in and out of those closets, really rehearse it with precision and then play it with heart.